Hi everyone, John here. Welcome back to another Continuum tutorial. Continuum 2023.5 was just released, and I created this fiery text look as part of the Continuum release. And I wanted to, in this tutorial, break this down and show you exactly how I created it. And this is going to be a two-part tutorial. In this part, I'm going to show you how I created this fiery look. But in the second part, I'm going to show you how you can create your own particles, export them as sequences, and then bring them into Particle Illusion. And we're going to modify this look using those imported particles. So if you've downloaded the file, open it up. If you don't have Continuum, you can download a trial version from the website. So get that installed and let's go. All right, so this is using the new particle masking feature that's included in Continuum 2023.5. And I'm working here in After Effects. So let's start with the text, because I'm using the text as the particle mask. Now, I'll just solo the text layer, and you can see there's the BCC burnt film effect applied. I'm just going to turn that off just for a sec, and come up to layer number 5. So this is the main flames layer. So using a nice flame particle inside Particle Illusion, and you can see how the text is emitting the particles. And that's because in BCC Particle Illusion, under Particle Masking, we've chosen Use Mask for Particle Creation. And for the mask layer, I've chosen Fire. So the text is creating the particles or emitting the particles. So that's really nice. It's a great new feature in this version. I'll just turn the text off just for a moment, and you can see how that's looking really nice there. Now, what I want you to notice here with the flames layer is that in After Effects here, I've chosen effects and masks, okay? Because as we saw just a moment ago, the fire layer, we have this BCC burnt film effect applied. And Particle Illusion is looking at the alpha channel of the text layer. So what I'll do is I'll just come down to the text and turn that back on. And see how it changed? So look at the alpha channel and turn the text on. You can see how it's only going to emit particles from the areas where there's pixels. So the area where the burnt film hasn't burned the layer out or burned the layer off, which is, you can see where I'm going here, which is really nice. So I can control where the flames are based on the percent done of BCC burnt film. If we increase the percent done, bring that right up, see how we get less and less flames or fewer and fewer flames? Isn't that nice? So we can burn the layer away. Now, we can't keyframe this currently. It's not possible in Particle Illusion, but it still is a great thing to be able to do. So the only thing I'm using in BCC Burn Film is the percent done. BCC burn film is a great effect by itself. You can actually use, you know, colors. You can choose colors for burn, flare, and char. You can also choose various layers for burn, flare, and char. So you can create quite realistic burnt film looks just using this effect. But for this look, I'm only using it for the percent done. And I'm using it because I like the way it burns the layer off, which makes sense because I'm doing things with fire and wood. All right. So just again, the key thing I wanted to point out here is that I've used effects and masks. If I didn't choose that, then Particle Illusion would only recognize the source, and that's the entire text layer. So it would emit particles from the entire text layer. So it's important that I chose effects and masks, so Particle Illusion sees that burnt film effect in this comp. Okay? All right, so great little After Effects feature there, and really handy in this case. Okay, so let's see. What I'll do is I'll turn the fire off. And let's take a look at these two layers down here, wood and charred wood. All right, so here's my wood. And if we double click that, inside here I have a free image from pexels.com. You can download your own image. You'll see this here, replace me. So put your own wood image in there. And I'm just going to hit tab, left arrow key. Come back to here. And there's a bunch of effects here. So let's just turn those all off. And there's the wood. So the first one is set matte. So for the mat, what are we using? We're using the fire layer. So this number 8 fire layer, and you can see how we've got the burn film being applied, but we're actually seeing the timber, okay? And if we come back to the fire and just decrease that, there we go. Because we're using the fire layer as the mat, we'll see more of the wood or timber. Let's call it wood from now on. What's the next effect? Next effect is BCC mat choker. Now the reason I put mat choker in here is because I didn't like the sharp, sharp lines. So a little bit of mat choker just, you know, soften that up a little bit. Next I use BCC edge grunge. And you can see how that's really given a nice sort of fiery, burned away look. Just open that up and just decrease the burn width. You can see how that gives that a nice sort of burned away look. What else have I adjusted here? If I just press U twice on the keyboard, I've adjusted burn progression. Here we go. So let's just adjust that. So a bit of burn progression in there. Burn intensity. Just tweak that a little bit to give that sort of burned away edge. And I actually also use After Effects' own rough and edges effect with that to affect some of these other edges as well. I'm going to undo a couple of times. There we go. And just turn rough and edges on too. So let's just bring back a little bit more of the actual text. There we go. And let's just turn the rough and edges on and off. There we go. So it's very similar to the BCC Edge Grunge. Rough and Edges has various edge types. I've just chosen Rusty in this case. If I increase the border, you can see how that eats away at that as well. So I just use a little combination of both. I just felt that together they worked quite well. All right, so that's the wood. Once again, we can see the alpha channel in there. And beneath that, we have the charred wood. So as the wood gets burned away, we see the charred version underneath. Now, I couldn't get exactly the same timber. What I did for charred wood is just found a different image. And it didn't have to be exact. I probably could have treated the original wood image and made that look burned. But it looked a lot better, I thought, to choose or find an image that actually was burned wood. A lot more realistic. Now, I did adjust this with a couple of effects. That was the actual original image. You can see how it's quite bright on this side because of the light source. So I used a levels effect. Just mask that off just to darken that down. You can see I've adjusted it. And I also used a curves adjustment layer just to make that a little more warm, a little warmer. Like that. And you'll see this image. So you need to replace it with your own image. All right, so that's charred wood. Let's close these ones up. And we've got that beneath the wood layer. Now this has also got some effects applied. Let's just turn those off. Make sure we can see that more easily. And there's set mat. Okay, so we're using the text as the mat, the fire text. Beneath that we have mat choker. Just to soften again, soften those edges. BCC edge grunge, just to grunge that up a little bit. And roughen edges, okay? Now, notice how if I twirl up and set mat again, that the fire layer is only using the source. So the charred wood isn't using BCC burn film. So it's not getting burned away. If I chose effects and masks, then it would get burned away because now it's recognizing that effect. But you can see where I'm going here. What we're doing is we're burning the good timber away and revealing the charred version of it. If I come back to fire and just increase that, see as it burns away, we reveal that charred version. Really nice. And remember before we looked at the flames particle layer is also recognizing burn film. So the flames will only be on the good wood, and as it burns away, the flames will disappear on the charred wood. Nice, huh? All right. So keeping that in mind, now we've looked at those two layers, let's turn the flames back on. Layer number 5. So there's the flames. Like that. And again, let's come back to fire and just increase that percent done. So as that burns away, we see the particles are only being emitted from those small areas of the wood layer. Now, for the smoke, I'm going to talk about that. I'm going to talk about this other flames layer in a moment. But for the smoke, also using particle illusion, it's basically the same setup, particle creation, using fire. But look, it's only using masks, not effects and masks. So the smoke isn't recognizing the BCC burn film layer. And the thinking behind that was that I figured that once the fire had burned away the wood, the charred wood would still be smoking, right? You'd still see that smoke a little bit. It would still be smoking. This made more sense to not use the BCC burn film. I thought that was quite effective. And I've done the same for these two embers layers. So I might just solo that by alt-clicking on the solo button. And I've got some fast particles being emitted. And you can see I've got particle creation, mask layer fire, and effects and masks. Because I figured the embers would only really be around where the flames were. Once the flames had burned the wood away, we wouldn't necessarily be seeing embers coming from that. And the second embers layer is just a duplicate, just to sort of brighten it up. You see, it just brightens that up. So if we just turn the wood on and just can see how they're only being emitted from those small areas. As we come back to the fire and just decrease that, we'll see that they're emitted from larger areas because there's more text. Nice, huh? So we've got the smoke, we've got the flames, and it's starting to look pretty good. Now the second flames layer, let me just turn these off and turn this on. The second flames layer is slightly different. We have a look at the effect. For this one, it's not using particle creation. It's using render mask standard. And notice how it's also using mask layer fire 2. So mask layer fire 2 is the same text, and it has BCC burnt film applied, but it has BCC blur. So it's slightly blurred. Now, I just want to walk you through this. Why did I do it this way? If we turn this flames on and come back to that layer, if I chose mask layer fire, the one without the blur, see how it's a really sharp edge? Because render mask standard is basically a cookie cutter mask. It's a standard sort of compositing mask, and it leaves a very sharp edge. And if I chose render mask full particles, it shows the entire flame. And I didn't want to see the entire flame. I just wanted to have some brighter, flamey areas, but not see the entire flame. So that's why I chose fire 2. And render mask standard. So I just added a few more flames onto the text. So that's with the other flames. If I turn that on and off, that's what it looked like. I just thought that added a little more to it. And it also helped it kind of glow around the edges. But because I chose render mask standard and not render mask full particles, we're not seeing the particles beyond the edge. The reason we're seeing it just slightly sticking out is because I've blurred the text. If I turn that blur off, you can see it goes sharp again. Okay, Now, notice with BCC Burnt Film on Fire Layer 2, there's a whole bunch of expressions applied. Because we have two of exactly the same text layers, and both of them have BCC Burnt Film applied, in order to keep those in sync, all I've done is selected Burnt Film on the main fire layer and chosen Edit, Copy with Property Links. And then on the duplicate, I've pasted. And that links all of the parameters together. So any changes I make to the Burnt Film on Fire 1 will change on Fire 2. All right. So I'm going to turn everything else back on. There we go. And the only other thing I have beneath the smoke, because I didn't want to apply glow to the smoke, is BCC Film Glow. So I'll just turn that on. And that gives it a really beautiful glow. Remember, BCC Film Glow has that secondary glow as well. And I've made that a fairly deep red. All right, so that's a pretty fast walkthrough. Have a play with it, and then join me in the next tutorial where we'll create some custom smoke and custom fire particles, and we'll switch these out and see if we can make it look even more realistic. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next tutorial.